the only Daryl Braithwaite joins us live to celebrate 25 years since his classic hit topped the charts.
Gee whiz, sounds like yesterday, doesn't it? Daryl, coming up a little bit later. Lisa's looking forward to it, as we all are.
And the one and only Daryl Braithwaite is joining us live very soon to celebrate 25 years since this classic song went to number one.
How good is that? There's Lisa. A little soft curl there.
I wish.
Righto. Behind you, Lisa.
Horses. Way up in the sky. Oh, don't we love that song? How fabulous is it? And how good is this clip?
It's unreal. Takes you right back.
Sure does.
Takes me back to an Antioch weekend when I was a young Christian soldier.
Really? You must tell us about it sometime.
25 Catholic years. Girls, eh?
It is. It is 25 years since that iconic Australian anthem hit the number one spot on the Aussie charts. And I'm pleased to say that the one and only Daryl Braithwaite joins us live. Round of applause.
Yeah.
Good morning to you, Daryl. Does it feel like 25 years to you? Because to us, it feels like yesterday.
Oh, yeah. Well, looking at that clip, and I thought, God, did I tuck my pant or the jumper into the pants?
Yeah, that was very 80s.
Nothing wrong with that.
Which was that's a bit weird, but no, it doesn't seem like 25. It's I don't know what. I never imagined it would, you know, go this long.
Can you give us any history on the song? The Ricky Lee Jones, I think, springs to mind as one of my favourites. And then you did it, and it's always a big deal to take on someone's song who does it so iconically like she did, but you made it your own. How did it all come about?
Well, we were finishing off recording of the Rise album in Melbourne.
Great album.
And I got home, and for some reason I pulled out the Flying Cowboys CD, which is Ricky Lee Jones's
album.
And I put that on and I heard The Horses and I thought, gee, I've got to ring Simon Hussey, who's the producer, and tell him that we've got to try and fit this in onto the Rise album, because I think it could sound similar to maybe As the Days Go By. Anyway, took it in and they looked at me with that look of, okay, well, I guess you're the lead singer. we'll go with it. And lo and behold, Sony, you know, picked it as a single, and I think it was the second or third single off that album. And they persevered with it, to their credit, Sony. It took a long time, and then it finally got to number one, about 25 years ago today.
Well, exactly 25 years ago.
Yeah.
Daryl, it was a great time for you. You'd had all that early success with Sherbet, of course, and the Edge album was a smash hit, a comeback album, if you want to call it. And then the Rise album and this song, I mean, it was a glorious time for you, wasn't it?
It was, there was a lot of in the right place at the right time, and a lot of people, you know, working behind the scenes that made it work. And I've got to thank them as well today, you know, and rightly so. It was, and then we've persevered, you know, like the band and I now, we love working live, and it just seems like we've grabbed a different audience, a new audience again over the last decade.
Mm. So. And despite the tucking in of the jumper into the pants, Daryl, the song itself is a classic. And the clip is completely timeless. What was the story behind shooting that? I think it was up in the Whitsundays, wasn't it?
No, well, it was at Bar Beach, just about 80K north of Newcastle.
Wow.
Oh, really?
And looks like Whitehaven there.
Doesn't it?
Yeah.
Well, it could be. And there's that guy about to jump or whatever. Yeah, unbelievable. Those jumps are gone now, but that's all right.
Catching the butterflies.
But it was a great day filming. It was, and then we went, that's right, I remember going back to Sydney and doing a gig at St George Leagues that night. and burnt to a crisp.
Hey, Daryl, we should give a bit of a shout out to Margaret Ehrlich as well. You know, her harmony on the song, on the record, she's not in the video, but her vocal was a... No, that's not her.
Who was that?
That's Gillian Matthews, I think, the model.
Yeah, that's right.
But Margaret's harmony was a huge part of the success of the song, I would suggest.
Rightly so, Richard, an integral part of the song. And she, unfortunately, couldn't be there for the shooting of the video. And I ran into her maybe 8 years after it came out up in Newcastle area. And I think she had a couple of children and all that, and she was still happy and singing and all that. But no, it did a great job of singing. I remember she was laying down her track when I was in, for some reason, I was in Beijing back then. And I remember hearing her in the background singing her part.
So wow.
It was fantastic, yeah.
I never knew that.
No,
that
clip. Me either.
Daryl, you spoke earlier about grabbing a new audience. I was 5 years old when it was released.
Oh, good on you, Sylvia.
But I have not been to a single wedding where the night hasn't ended with everyone at the wedding standing in a circle, arms around each other, swaying and singing along to that song. You're still touring non-stop as well. Do you think you'll ever get sick of performing that song?
No, I never do, because it changes every night, the reaction to it. I mean, we love playing it as well, yeah.
It's a high song, Daryl. Do you ever wish you'd recorded a couple of times?
I do the karaoke.
Some nights it's just, it's really, I'll let you in on a little set. Just when we started, even last night here in Darwin, and it gets to the, we will fly, you got to sing that in full voice.
Wow.
No, but it's just, It always worries me, and it seems to happen as you get older for some reason.
Daryl, I've had an idea. It says that you're not even warmed up, but I think it'd be an ideal opportunity without music accompaniment, for you and Lisa just to have a little go. Look, a little
duet. Are we sure about this, Daryl?
Come on.
Well, how do we do it, Lisa?
You start off, Daryl.
We will. Oh, we got to go. That's the way it's gonna be, little darling. We'll go riding on the horses,
ooh.
Way up in the sky, little darling. And if you fall, pick you up.
That's your bit.
She'll pick you up, all right. Nice.
Daryl knows he was my teenage crush, and it's never gone away.
Hey, we should give Daryl's tour a bit of a plug.
Huge.
Too. The Apia tour, you're in there on Darwin. Correct me if I'm wrong, but that was the first night last night, yeah?
Yeah, last night Darwin, then Adelaide is next.
You're on the road with JPY and Rangy John Stevens, and Kate Sobrano's got a big hit album. Yeah, congratulations on the tour, mate. All the best with that.
Thank you, Richard, and thanks to everyone there for having us on this morning.
Oh, we love you.
Thanks, Daryl.
Love you to sing how bad.
Okay.
Take care, Daryl.
Thank you.
It's great to see all those great acts, back popular.
Yes,
absolutely.
Just some terrific music. Yeah. The songs we lived our life by. Hey, Dickie.
Oh, Carla.
Except for Sylvia.
I'm still living it. I was living it on Saturday night.
Why don't you go get stuff, Sylvia? You and your youngness.
Sylvia's
still to come. We're giving away cash. Rocky's got...